But when we have fractions with denominators that are different, we have to take a couple of steps before we can add them, okay?
Okay.
All right, so let's look at the steps here that we have to take. So when we're adding fractions with different denominators, the first thing we do is we're going to model the fractions, and then we're going to find multiples of the denominators. The third thing is we determine the lowest common denominator. Next, we determine how many new sets of each fraction you need and make them. And then the last thing is you add. Okay. All right. All right, so let's look at these two fractions here. What is this first fraction?
It's 1/4.
Good, and what is the second fraction?
2/3.
2/3, good. All right, so what is the first thing we need to do?
We need to model the fraction.
Good, model the fraction. So we're going to use these to model the fractions, okay? So the denominator tells us how many equal parts are in a set.
4.
Good, so there are 4 equal parts in a set. So we're going to put 4 pieces to model the 4 equal parts, all right? Mm-hmm. And then what does the numerator tell us?
There's one numerator.
So good. The numerator tells us how many pieces are represented, right? So we're representing 1 out of 4. So 1/4, right?
1/4.
1/4. Good. So we're gonna move this up here. And what's our next fraction?
2/3.
2/3. So how many total pieces are there in our set?
3.
3. Good. So let's get out 3 pieces. And how many pieces are represented?
There are 3 pieces represented, and for a numerator, there's two numerators.
So the numerator is 2, which tells us there are 2 parts being represented, right?
Right.
Good. So there are 1/2 out of 3. So 2/3, right?
Mm-hmm.
Good. So now, what is the next thing we do? We've modeled the fraction. What do we do next?
Find multiples of the denominator.
Find multiples of the denominator. Good. So let's start with the 1/4. What is the denominator in 1/4?
Denominator in 1/4 is the 4.
4. Good. So we're going to write the 4 right here in our model. And we're going to... So when we find multiples, we can think of it as multiplying, okay?
Okay.
So we're going to multiply... We're going to find the first five multiples of the denominator, so of 4, okay? All right, so what is 4 times 1?
1.
Are you sure?
I mean, 4.
Oh, that's all right. Good. So what is 4 times 2?
8.
Good. What is 4 times 3?
12.
12. Good. What is 4 times 4?
16.
16. Good. And 4 times 5?
20.
20, good. And let's do our next denominator. What's the other denominator?
2/3.
So the fraction is 2/3, and what's the denominator?
That's 3.
3, good. So we're going to write the other denominator right there, and we're going to do the same thing. We're going to find the first 5 multiples of 3, okay?
Okay.
All right, so what's 3 times 1?
3 times 1 is 3.
Good. 3 times 2?
3 times 2 is 6.
Good. 3 times 3?
3 times 3 is 9.
9. And 3 times 4?
3 times 4 is 12.
Good. And 3 times 5?
3 times 5 is 6. No, 15.
15, good. Alright, so we have found the multiples, and what's the next thing we do?
We determine the lowest common denominator.
Lowest common denominator, good. So we have all these multiples of the two denominators, and we have to find the numbers that are the same, okay? So which number do both of these tests have in common?
They both have in common. They have 2s in common.
So what's this number?
12.
12, so they both have 12s in common, right?
Right.
Good, so let's circle those numbers, 12 and 12. All right, so we've found the lowest common the lowest common denominator, and so what do we do after that?
We determine how many new sets of each fraction you need to make them.
Good. So, to do that, we see how many times we have to multiply to get the lowest common denominator. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So, with the 4, we multiplied 1, 2, 3 times, right? Mm-hmm. So, to get the 12, we multiply 4 times 3, right? So, how many sets of the 1/4 do we need?
3
sets, good. So we already have one set here. Alright, so we're going to come back to it and make those sets in a little bit, okay?
Okay.
Alright, but now let's see how many times we had to, how many sets of the 2/3 we need, alright?
Alright.
So count with me as we see how many sets we're going to need, alright? So we multiply
1, 2, 3, 4.
Good, so we multiplied 3 how many times to get 12?
We need to multiply it 4 times.
Good. So we need how many sets?
We need 4 sets.
4 sets. Good. All right. So let's make those different sets. So with the 1/4, how many sets do we need?
12. I mean 3.
3 sets. Good. So we already have one set. So let's make 2 more sets.
And now, what is...
So does this one need to be red or yellow? Good. Awesome. So we have 3 sets of the 1/4. And how many sets of the 2/3 do we need?
We need 4.
4 sets. Good job. So we already have 1. How many more sets do we need?
We need 3 more.
Good. So do we have 4 sets for 2/3?
Yes.
Good job. All right, so the circle, the numbers that we circled represent our new denominator, okay? Mm-hmm. So we need to, in each of these, we need to see if there are 12 total pieces now, all right? So let's count it together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Are there 12 there?
Yeah.
Good. So let's count it and see if we have 12 up here too, all right?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
So do we have 12 there?
Yes.
Awesome. Good job. All right. So now, what is the last thing we need to do?
Combine all the fractions.
So we need to combine the fraction sets. All right. So I'm going to make sets of 12. All right. Using these counters, I'm going to make sets of 12. All right. I'm going to start with the red ones first, though, all right? Because that'll tell us what our numerator is, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, so let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Have we gotten to 12 yet?
No.
No, so what do we need to do? We're going to get one more. Good. One more, good. All right, so now, how many yellow ones do you think we have left?
We have 12 left.
12 left, good. So we can make this a set of its own, but we're not going to really use these because they don't really represent anything, okay? All right, thank you. All right, so we're looking at the red ones to represent our new numerator, okay?
Okay.
All right, so when we add these, the red ones are going to represent our numerator, and how many total there are going to represent our denominator, okay? All right, so let's count how many red ones there are to figure out our numerator, okay? So let's count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
So what's our numerator?
Our numerator is 11.
11, good job. And what is our denominator going to be? How many total pieces are there in this line?
12.
12, good. So 1/4 plus 2/3 equals
12. I mean, equals 11, 12.
Good job. Awesome.